20. Why take that?
Hello, everybody, and welcome to Madden NFL 18. I'm Brandon Gauden, and the first step here is simple. Select your favorite team. It's time to select your play style. So do you want a fast-paced, up-tempo game? That's arcade. An authentic NFL experience in simulation or in the competitive arena where stick skills are paramount. Now remember, you can always change your play style in the settings menu. Okay, experience level. Beginner and intermediate, that's where we help you along the way. We'll give you some visual assistance as you play, as you learn the game. Advanced, that's where you take the training wheels off. And expert, as we have there, proceed with caution. That's for the top game players. Hey, Brandon Gauden here, and it's time to take a look at what's new in Madden NFL 18, powered by Frostbite. First up is game styles. Choose what style best fits you. Now, arcade is to play a more wide-open game filled with big plays. Simulation is an authentic NFL experience, and then competitive, our online head-to-head default where stick skills are king. Looking for an immersive narrative experience? Long Shot is an all-new story mode letting you step into the shoes of NFL hopeful Devin Wade as you guide him on his path to the NFL draft. In Play Now Live, follow along with the NFL season with updated commentary and real season stats from NFL.com. Franchise mode is back. Customize your level of personnel management to start the season. Utilize your all-new draft board and follow along with a real NFL schedule and jump in at any point during the season to try and rewrite history. Finally, grab up to two of your friends, combine your ultimate team decks, choose your roles, and take on all comers online in the brand new Mutt Squads. Madden NFL 18. It's a Madden for everyone and Madden like you've never seen it before. There you have it. Simple as that. All done. Now get out there and bottom line, most importantly, have some fun. Enjoy Madden NFL 18.
this ambition. A couple million make you stand different. They drop the ball.
Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. It's hard to imagine this not being a fun game to watch. It's the Patriots going up against the Lions. With that, it's time to hook up with our commentators in the booth as we turn it over to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Larry, first opened in 2002. There's a look inside Ford Field here in downtown Detroit. Both teams emerging from the Ford Field tunnels just a short time ago. Of course, the Lapa Reserve and Town Lions, they're set to go as they will match up the New Englands. And everyone, Brandon Gott, Charles Davis, and CD, week three of the preseason. We're getting there, opening night on the horizon. Madden video game out on Friday the 25th, so you know we're close. But this is the week you use as your dress rehearsal, isn't it?
Yeah, you certainly do. Now, the guys that know they're going to make this team and have be difference makers in the season, looking forward to the Madden game being released in this game, but this is the one, as you said, is dress rehearsal. You want it to be exactly going to be on opening day, and they'll regulate the play time of the starters, but they want them to be out there just like they're playing a regular game for the time that they play.
That's fielded in the end zone, and he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Leading out the New England Patriots, number 12, Tom Brady, who you thought had done everything in his illustrious career.
What do you mean he has?
Until this week, he graced the cover of Madden for the first time.
You're exactly right, because I had thought he had done everything he possibly could have in his career, but the first time on the cover of Madden, congratulations to Tom Brady, and congratulations, football fans. The GOAT on the cover.
Brady now on first down, and Cooks has it over the middle, and they're able to get this one across the 35. That'll be a New England first down, a gain of 12.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to create the yardage that they got, but it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds, because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you? Down is Brady. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Now let's give you a look here at the New England offense.
Let's be honest about it. Everyone in the NFL competes, but Julian Edelman, he really competes. Transitioned from a college quarterback to a slot receiver in the NFL, and he thinks that no one can cover him just by sheer force of will. Scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. They go play action here on first down. Oh, he can't get away, and Brady will go down. Akeem Spence. With a great push up front, he picks up the sack and a loss of 8.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. The quarterback was hit.
Gun. Solid move, but he's corralled just beyond the 40. They get 2 yards back, but they're going to need a lot more than that here on third down. The Lions here on defense, they're starting 11. Worth noting, a defensive end, Kerry Hyder, lost for the year with an Achilles injury.
And that's a big blow to the Lions because he was so well-liked in that locker room and came out of nowhere to become a quality starter for them in 2016. But if they get Ziggy Ansah, their star defensive end, back at his level of 2015, that'll more than make up for the loss of Kerry Hyder, because Ansah is an absolute terror going after the quarterback.
On third and long, it's Brady. Letting one go deep for his running back, White. Hang on to it. Nearly picked. He's known for his hands defensively, but instead it just brings up fourth down. You know, last week I remember asking you, what would an offensive coordinator be looking for week two of the preseason? Now we're in week three. Defensive coordinator-wise, what's he looking at?
For the most part in preseason, you're playing pretty basic stuff, pretty vanilla defenses. You're looking for guys that play with abandon, that just go out and make plays. You kind of let their athletic ability take over in order for you to notice them.
Now after the punt on that play, we've got a man down on the field. Definitely the last thing you want to see here in a preseason game. We'll be right back. Down at Stafford. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete and able to get it here to about the 16-yard line. 4 yards on the pickup, and it'll make it second down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
A first carry for Amir Abdullah. Brought down around the 16 or 17. Had a nice move, but couldn't free much space. Call it a gain of a yard, and it's going to bring up third and five.
I once had a defensive player in the NFL tell me, if I beat and dominate the guy across from me, I'm helping my team. Well, winning one-on-one battles is always a part of the game, but when you have good team defense, as we just saw there, one broken tackle, but he didn't get away because the rest of the guys arrived to put him on the ground.
Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. They give him 7 yards on the play, and they do pick up the conversion on third down.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of your football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
Stafford looks to throw again. To the right side to Eric Ebron. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. Stafford finding his big tight end Ebron for a Lion first down. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger game. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
They'll give him 8 on the play, and it'll bring up a second down.
I'm not sure that this play was designed for him specifically, but they got through the progressions and got the ball to him. So, second catch on the drive. He may not be a
trying for White, and it's intercepted. Able to get there and pick it. And his guys are going to take over at their own 48-yard line. So, possession changes hands on the final play of the first quarter. Nothing, our score. We're back to the Motor City after this. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
The NFL on EA Sports is fueled by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
They take over first and 10 up near midfield. So after the INT, it's Brady. Over the middle, that's taken in by Gronkowski. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. That goes as a gain of 11 and a Patriot first down.
Well, there it is, partner. Brady to Gronk, their first connection of the game.
You think those two often in sync?
I don't think there's any question about it. And look, we know Gronk has a whole lot of fun, but he's deadly serious about his football, as is Tom Brady. Two great competitors, two fantastic players.
They're able to push forward for about four down to the 37. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
Now Brady throwing on second down. Going deep here for Edelman. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third. And this is a guy straight out of college. They're not going to try to groom for a year or two. They want him to produce right away.
That's why they took him in the first round. They expect him to be a starter right away and a future all-pro. So they don't have any time to wait for him to come along. They want him to play right now to help this team.
Really, it's a solid draft class from a year ago. They were able to address some key weak spots on their team and fill in some holes.
And they were able to identify the players they wanted early in the process. Got a little bit of luck, as some guys may have fallen to them. But for the most part, knew their philosophy and stuck to it.
He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far. And after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. Brady to throw on second down. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
The one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept him on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Throwing is Brady on third down. And now a fumble. Brady loses the football.
Like this, when the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back, because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from it. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
So on fourth down, Brady will yield to Gostkowski for the field goal try. This from 54 yards away. And the 11-year veteran bangs it through, and the Patriots jump out to a 3-0 lead. And we were scoreless up until this point in the second quarter. Now we finally have a little action.
Let's see where this action takes us. First quarter, no points at all. Now we've got our first score of the game. Well, does that signal that we're going to get more as we go along, or will it revert back to what we saw in the beginning of the game?
Here comes the field general leading his offense back out there for the next possession. And he comes out on the heels of an interception he threw last time they had the ball.
Yeah, and you know, the quarterbacks that I know that are the best ones, the ones that really know how to lead their team, they tell them, that's on me. That's my bad. But let's go back out there and move ahead again, guys. We can get this done.
One good thing for him, it did only lead to 3 points and not a touchdown after that turnover.
Big thanks to the defense.
And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
While we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore, I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion and both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. From the gun, here's Stafford. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
And here now the punter, Martin, booming this one away. And a fair catch taken here right at about the 40-yard line. A 40-yard punt, no return, and the Patriots take over. All right, CD, you got a second. Ready to go on the hot seat?
Oh, man. Already?
This season? Going to call this segment, you're the coach.
All right.
In Denver, Houston, Cleveland, Jacksonville, week one, who are you starting at quarterback?
All right, let's take them individually then. Denver, I'm starting Trevor Siemian. Who was the second team?
Houston,
I am starting Deshaun Watson. Who's the third team?
Cleveland.
I'm starting Deshaun Kizer.
Okay, and then Jacksonville,
I'm starting Blake Bortles. I'm starting him ahead of Chad Henne. I'm telling him, sink or swim, this is your year.
I like that. Going on the record and very decisive, I might add.
Yeah, how about that? And Patrick Mahomes won't start for Kansas City to begin the season, but he may be the starter when they head towards the playoffs.
2 minutes to go here in the first half. We'll come back to Ford Field after this. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, we'll send you to Orlando and Larry Ridley, as he'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. But no touchdowns. These guys need to give Larry some touchdowns to talk about.
Things are too easy for him right now back in the studio. Come on, guys. Help the man out. Give him something to talk about.
On first down, Brady. Allen's got it over the middle. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
On second down, here's Brady. Throw complete right side to Cooks. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. Brady connecting with Cooks for the Patriot first down. That time a slant, Brady in general on those quick hitters, he just releases the ball so fast.
He does, and he's so accurate, but most of the time, he wins before the ball's even snapped by his pre-snap read. Finds out where the defense is and delivers it to the proper place.
Brady now on first down. The throw left side complete to Hogan. And he is out of bounds, but not before taking this inside the 10 to the 7. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. This offense can certainly move quickly when they want to. Three plays, three pass completions. In the blink of an eye, they've got a first and goal.
Almost felt like a lightning bolt hit in this game, didn't it? For them to get downfield that quickly. And now first and goal. Expect them to tackle right here on this play.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal.
Warren!
Brady to throw again. And this is caught. It's Edelman. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Julian Edelman, a 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Patriots add on to their lead.
It's never fun for a defense to run on the field knowing that they're having to defend a short field. Just the idea of trying to limit an offense in that position, daunting for a defense.
It's up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 10-0. Just a four-play drive that time. And it ends with a New England touchdown. Fielded about a yard deep. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. A reminder, opening weekend definitely in sight. Thursday, September 7th is when it all begins. The top two seeds in the AFC playoffs last year, Kansas City at New England. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off by Dante Hightower. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line. That's sort of a second quarter to forget for him. Now two picks in this frame.
Almost as if the first one that he threw, he couldn't shake, couldn't get it out of his head. He ends up throwing a second one as a result.
Compounds the mistake a little bit.
Yeah, you got to be able to forget, compartmentalize, whatever you want to call it.
And now a fumble. Brady loses the football. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. So the offense avoids disaster, keeps possession. Now it's second down. Shotgun now for Brady. Wide open, Julian Edelman. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15, just shy of the 10. Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. And the next snap coming inside the red zone here. On first and 10, here's Brady. And this is complete. It's Allen. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Dwayne Allen, a 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Patriots.
Heard a coach talk about those late in the half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. Scoring summary, three-play drive, and it's finished off by a Pats touchdown. On the return, Dwayne Washington. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. And making their way back out there now, the Patriots defense. Now the interception for them the last time, and that turned into 6 points.
You think during their break they reminded the offense that, hey, we helped you guys out a little bit, right? You know, they want to see if they can do it again for them. They're putting together an entire team game by how they're playing on defense.
Drive, what will happen here? Call it a gain of 3, and that'll make this a second down. And now they come up and spike it to stop the clock. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. The Lions on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. A shotgun snap for Stafford. And it falls incomplete after almost being intercepted. A pick there would have been great. The good news for the defense now, it's 4th down.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And possession will change here with very little time remaining until halftime. They'll start things on first down with Deion Lewis. And he'll take this one up close to the 25-yard line. And now a timeout defensively after that first down play. So they're going to make this offense sweat out half number one. Double tight, guys, double tight. And with time running down, they go down to a knee. So at halftime, it's the Patriots with the advantage. As we'll send you down to Orlando, where Larry Ridley has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
Okay, Brandon, thanks. And welcome, everyone, to our EA Sports Halftime Report. Let's get to the highlights. The Lions trail at home at halftime. The Patriots will want to come out after the half and really put the pressure on from the start. So here we go. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Patriots have it at the 7. Brady's gonna find his mark, but a quick three-play drive ends with a score.
Don't worry, Larry. If this were a regular season game, people would be thrilled to watch your halftime highlight show. But instead, in week 3 of the preseason, we need to get to the third quarter. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Lions offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number 3. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working and call more of that.
Here's Stafford now on second down. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off by Eric Rowe. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Patriot defense has a touchdown. This D wanted to put it away before we even get to the fourth quarter, widening that margin a bit further.
And while they won't just empty the bench just yet, if you're a backup, start loosening up. I think I'll get a chance to play before this one is over now with that type of a cushion.
And the lead is now 24. So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This is taken at the 3. Here's the Detroit offense now as they head back out onto the field. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is just what you said. You've gone over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
It's a loss of 2, now third down.
If these guys are going to chop into that deficit, they got to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage will be found.
Here's Stafford. Oh, he almost intercepted it. They're just forcing it into too many tough spots. That was almost a 4th pick of the game. And now 4th down. Another drive comes and goes, still nothing on the scoreboard.
Yeah, and when the second half comes, you know, it's real easy to get discouraged and wonder if you're ever going to get things started. But just got to fight through it. Got to keep pounding away.
NFL teams last year, a little under 50% on 4th down conversions. This is a bit tougher. 4th and 4. They are going to go for it. It's Stafford. It's complete. Swings it out to his running back. But he will be stopped behind the line as he will not come close to the marker. Boy, a curious decision to go for it doesn't pan out. And the Patriots take over. They're going to have terrific field position. Well, at this stage of the game in the second half, down 3 scores, I guess they felt like they needed to push.
And let's face it.
with this deficit, if they give up another score here after they didn't get it, does it really matter?
Right.
It really doesn't. They had to go and try and make something happen if they had any chance of winning this game.
And he'll get them inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. Again, it's Lewis. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. Looking to throw on second down. Brady. And down he goes. Pressure gets him back at the 14. Ezekiel Ansah in there to drop him for his second sack now here tonight.
That's his second sack of the game. And the best defensive ends, they do their homework as much as offensive guys do. They know how to beat the offensive linemen across from them, what moves they need to do to set them up. This guy's been pretty good at it all game long.
Tough spot for the Pats now after the sack as Brady will lead him up third and long. Working from the gun, it's Brady. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
So the drive stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board. Gostkowski now converted for three. Now he'll kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he will be marked down right there at the 20-yard line. And Detroit getting set to go now. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough because we always talk about it being a team game and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who could make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
On second down, here's Stafford. A dump off for Abdullah. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. And before they can run this third down play, we're going to get a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. The Lions on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This will be third and five. Out of the gun, Stafford. Ebron caught left side. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. So in their own territory, but they only need a few inches, so they're going to opt to go for this thing. We'll see. Maybe a surprise pass. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by the linebacker, David Harris. And he'll return it to the 24-yard line. Well, Charles, he's thrown 5 picks in a game before, and right now, after that one, he's standing on number 4.
And right now, your defensive coordinator is asking the offensive coordinator, can you do anything to slow this down? Because my guys have to keep running back out on the field. So play calling may come into it a little bit, maybe run the ball a little bit more. But a lot of it depends on the scoreboard. They may have to keep throwing.
Lewis.
And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. That goes as a gain of 11 and a Patriot first down.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third. Back now at Ford Field. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number four. They'll run it here. This is James White. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. James White, a 12-yard touchdown run. And the Pats take advantage of field position on the turnover to cash this one in.
There's no doubt in my mind.
And do you hear that? Do you hear the...
It's not scales, right? No. I don't hear scales. Do I actually hear a tune being warbled?
I think the fat lady's humming.
Yeah, she's doing more than humming. She's belting it out right now.
She's going. She's full bore.
Yeah, this thing is flat out finished.
Gostkowski now out to kick it away. This fielded at the two. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21-yard line. And Detroit getting set to go now. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. Over the middle, it's Fells. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Now, after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. Definitely the last thing you want to see here in a preseason game. We'll be right back. Here we go with second and seven.
Hey, watch the left, watch the left. I got it.
They'll look to throw here. And a big loss here as he's taken down.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop and it can often hit big, but sometimes they take too long to develop and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz, and even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz called and you still cover the screen, now that allows your blitzers to get there.
It'll be a gain of eight, but it also lead to a fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses, it's understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. Finding Fells complete. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. That'll be a gain of 15 yards. And on fourth and long, somehow they're able to keep the drive going. They'll look to throw here on first down. And that is incomplete. He was trying to get it to TJ Jones that time. And that'll bring up second down. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game. And to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on. And they just play better and better.
They'll be dropped shy of the full to tackle. Call it about a gain of three, and they'll be looking at a third and seven coming up.
Doesn't matter who you're rooting for in this game, the effort of the man with the football getting away from one and trying to turn forward and get some yardage, I really liked what he did there.
They'll set up to throw. And this is caught by Fells, right side. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. And now a whistle and a timeout called by the kicking team. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. A critical one here if they're going to have any shot at this thing. So they'll go for it on fourth down. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. That's to his running back, complete. He cannot wiggle free. They stop him at the line on fourth down. Jim Caldwell's guys cannot come through there on fourth down. And the Patriots take over. They're going to have terrific field position. And they'll start this drive with very good field position.
Let's go! Move, land it!
They'll run with White. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. Now I think we're going to get a timeout here. Yes, a timeout here as it looks like we've got a lion that's shaken up. Definitely the last thing you want to see here in a preseason game. We'll be right back.
Cut it left. Cut it left. Everyone come.
Yeah,
They keep it on the ground. White again. And this one also slow in developing as he's maybe getting back here to the line of scrimmage, but not much more than that. So nothing there, but maybe you blame that on the blocking.
Yeah, at some point, you've got to win at the point of attack, and on that play, that was all the defense. They made it happen.
The first throw here for the backup, Garoppolo, and that is incomplete.
Yeah, give some credit. They're able to hop up in the air and bat that one away. And that's frustrating for an offensive lineman because the only recourse is when he goes in the air to try and get some type of a pop or a shove, hoping to bring his arms down.
Here's Ryan Allen now as he'll kick it away for the second time. His first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. And Detroit getting set to go now.
Watch the screen! Watch the screen!
Hurry up! Here we go!
They'll come out throwing here on first down. Fells has it left side. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. So the Lions in possession of the football as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And it's caught by Keyshawn Martin. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down. Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now because now these plays are really for next week, trying to get some momentum going.
Open man, the tight end fails. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As he'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Back to throw now on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
Here we go.
Back to throw now on second and 10. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. They're going to look to throw, and he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. Now it's Matt Prater on for the Lion field goal try. On the left hash, officially it's called a 51-yard attempt. And this one is right down Broadway. And they'll get back three, but this remains a large deficit. Well, it's a Pyrrhic victory at best, but Charles, no team wants to get shut out, so it's hard to blame them for taking the three there.
You can't blame them one bit. It hasn't been the best performance, that's for darn sure. But there is something to be said for fighting to avoid the goose egg, and they're at least trying to finish out strong.
And this is secured by the Patriots. The fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
So they got him coming up from his linebacker spot.
And sometimes the position designation really doesn't matter. If you creep up to the line of scrimmage, you just have to look for the football. Make sure it moves before you do.
The Patriots in the victory formation as they'll take the knee. New England on third down. Just 1 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 8. A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you...
Choose yes to continue playing your team's season and control what happens next.
Yeah, since my early days, I've been stuck.
Customize your season experience before jumping into your next game.
Don't look at me in my face. Everybody might see my pain. Off the rail, might myself. But with life as aboard this plane, steward this sex if I need help. Maybe with your last name. Hopefully it still ain't been changed. Something about you make me not doubt you. I will satisfy my brain. Scream louder. Asking when I'm going myself. Couple problems, my cash ain't help. Human issues too strong for tissue. False provider, warm ass by wealth.
Move your body if you came here to party. If not, then pardon me. How I'm supposed to have a good time with death and destruction's all I see. Out of sight, I'm out of my mind. The sound of sunshine is calling me. The vibrations is all I need. All I need, all I need.
Party people, yeah. Party people, I'd like to see you dance. Party people, yeah. Party people, I'd like to see you dance. Party people, move. Party people, I'd like to see you groove. This is how we do. This is how we do. Deja vu from a bayside view. I see black cats in the daytime too. I see black cats on the daytime news. When handcuff wrist and his skin turn blue. I met God once at the rendezvous and felt starstruck.
Vince, the car's outside.
Got things to do, got to make my moves. I can't miss my flight and miss you too. Boo, first class seat is overrated. Won't go unless they overpay us. Nowadays I'm overdating my district for the hurt. Stay well acquainted, their morning is calling me. Good vibrations is all I need.
Everybody, I'm Larry Ridley. This is Madden 18 on EA Sports. It's hard to imagine this not being a fun game to watch. It's the Lions going up against the Bills. With that, let's welcome in our fine broadcast team.
Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
From the home of the Bills since 1973, there's a look at the newly named New Era Field just outside of Buffalo, New York. A few moments ago, to the delight of this Buffalo crowd, it was the Bills racing out of the tunnel as they get set to match up with Matthew Stafford and the Detroit Lions. Hello again, everyone. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, and partner, I think we can safely sum up the goal this final week of the preseason with three simple words. Don't get hurt.
And make sure you follow that mantra, okay? We cannot have you hurt going into the season, but you're exactly right. Starters will play very little, if at all, in this game.
And we drop you in here under the lights. First drive of the contest. The first carry for Amir Abdullah, and he'll get this one up to the 26. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. Second down following the run. From the gun, here's Stafford. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. So he got free of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. Call it a gain of 5. And they're going to face a third down. Just the first quarter, but tackling going to be so important going forward. They've got to limit plays like that.
And that's something when you see it happen early in the game and they don't get him on the ground, you can always tell that they were concerned about it going in. Because I can just tell you, from my days, I remember being in college and worrying all offseason about our season open opponent, and they had a receiver that could shake and bake with the best of them. I tackled him on the first pass of the game, and the relief was incredible. I ended up having a pretty decent ball game. But if I'd missed him, it would have been a
different
long
story.
Night.
So they will go for it. Stafford. And he connects with Ebron. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a first down.
On first down, it's Stafford. He goes underneath to Abdullah, and he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. Give him 9 on the play, and that'll make it second and short. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4 for 4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. Confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking to themselves and expressing, let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
They're just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
I don't believe that this opening drive is surprising to either one of us after the time we spent with the coaching staff and players prior to the game. What about you?
Absolutely. Not only that, but that big article in this paper this morning about their philosophy on starting games like you're shot out of a cannon, and that's what they've done. Very methodical here on this first drive.
Yeah, so many teams talk about that fast start. We're actually seeing it happen right here in front of us.
But now the kicker. Can they cap it off by putting the ball in the end zone? A gain of 6 there on first. And the pocket's been protected pretty good here so far on the opening drive.
We always talk about confidence in runners and catchers and quarterbacks. How about the detail? They're not allowing.
Throwing again at Stafford. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. Defensively, they better figure something out. Opening drive, he already has 4 catches.
And if you have to figure out how to stop him defensively, that usually means you weaken your defense. That means that now the offense is doing the dictating, and they should have other things open up as well.
All right, boys, here we go. On first down, Stafford here. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And down inside the 15 he goes. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. And so far, a very nice, methodical opening drive.
This has the feel of a scripted drive that they rehearsed perfectly all week long, and now they're executing it on game day.
Script looks good so far. Abdullah, no dice this go around. He's hit behind the line and taken down. That's going to go as a loss of four, and it'll be second down. So the Lions go backwards there, and unfortunately that's something they saw a lot in 2015. They had the fewest rushing yards of any team in the NFL.
As one of those dubious titles that no one really wants to claim. Even teams who say, well, I don't worry about running it because we throw it all the time. Being able to run it when you want to is a key to success in the NFL, and Detroit struggled doing that. Defense.
So give them the yardage on the pass and half the distance to the goal line.
Because they're inside the 30, so now you don't march off the full 15, right? You have half the distance to the goal. In any event, that's precious real estate given up.
A shotgun snap for Stafford. Oh, he nearly picked it. Maybe daylight in front of him if he could have held on. Instead, second down.
Used to have a coach just tell us all the time, those scouting reports aren't just to use up paper, guys. Well, nowadays, you know, we're watching a computer screen, right? They scouted this team very well. Know that they like to use the running backs in the passing game. They covered that play successfully.
Now Stafford. And he can't corral it. Maybe a big missed opportunity there defensively in the end zone. And now third down.
All right, Captain, it's batting down the hatches time defensively. Dodge two pass attempts to the end zone. Now what do you think they're going to try and dial up on third and goal?
Well, knowing them and knowing what we just seen, I think they're throwing it again, don't you?
I think you have to. I think in this situation, you kind of run out of your running plays, fire another one into the end zone.
And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4.
Brandon, this is why I'm really glad I'm sitting up here next to you. It's awfully tempting to go for it right here, isn't it? But it's been.
And the first play will be a field goal try from the right hash, and this one just a chippy. And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalpost, and the Lions are going to take a 3-0 lead. So they get the field goal, but part of that was a 14-play drive to get the 3. Normally, when you. Around the NFL there in the second quarter at Lambeau. Early lead in that one for the Packers. Aaron Rodgers with one touchdown pass thus far. Back to throw here. And he'll run it. And he will score. Touchdown, Lions. Theo Riddick taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Lions are in for 6. And there you go. Nothing really too complex. Block, keep to your assignments, let them run it in. They did it.
Fundamental football. Good blocking, beats good tackling on that play. End result, touchdown.
Martin the punter now out to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 as he's taken down right at the 20. Now the Bills offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Let's go! Green three.
From the shotgun, Peterman. Wide open receiver complete. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. That goes for a gain of 31. Now Peterman on first down. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield complete. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, a ball may come your way.
All right, here we go. Green 39. Green 39.
On first down, Peterman. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
He kind of forced that one there, didn't he? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
All right, here we go.
Second and 10, Peterman again. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15, just shy of the 10. Red zone opportunity.
Watch tight end. Watch tight end. Tight end's right. Tight end's right. Here we go now. Green 39.
They'll throw on first down with Peterman. And that'll be incomplete.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
Here we go now. Green 39. Green 39.
Second and 10 now, Peterman. A dump underneath to Jones. And I think we've got a hold here. It's a 5-yard pickup for the moment. Let's see what our referee says. So they say we'll let that completed pass stand and we'll bring up third down instead as they decline it.
So they're comfortable with the yardage. The big thing to them is what you pointed out, getting it to third down and making the play there.
Now it's Peterman. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. It's coming in to drop him for a loss of 8, and it'll be fourth down. Well, this has been a pretty sizable drive. They've had some success. Finally, the defensive coordinator found some success of his own.
I think he just simply said enough of that. Okay, they've moved the ball well. We need to force the issue from our end, and that's exactly what he did.
And Hauschka's kick is good. So we are halfway through. Larry, apologies. No halftime this week. I think we, like everyone, are anxious to get done with this preseason. So let's get straight to the action in the second half. Around the NFL there in the second quarter at Lambeau. Early lead in that one for the Packers. Aaron Rodgers, a single touchdown pass to this point in that one. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Out come the Bills now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. 10 yards still left on second down. They'll go again to Jones. And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. He only got a couple on that one, so not a ton of help. They'll have a 3rd and 8 forthcoming.
We know that old expression, it's not my night.
It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. On third down, Peterman. And this is going to be incomplete.
We're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off.
Let's go, Stans. Make some noise.
And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And the punt goes out of bounds. Where will they put it? They'll put it just inside the 45-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away. Defense,
we've got the lead.
Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see what the offense gets done.
They get six on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
If you're running out route, it's likely you're going to end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there? You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
They'll look to throw here on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Ryan Davis in there to bring him down for a loss of seven. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Man, that's just so difficult for them because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's really a difficult task. For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Oh, incomplete. Nearly the pick they needed. They would have loved one there, but at least it does get them to fourth down.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
Score will stay right where it is. So distance not the issue there. He had plenty of leg to get it there. It's that darn upright getting in the way.
Always gets in the way of a good time, doesn't it? Because he hit it square, too. Sometimes you can bank one in if you get it on the end of the football. No such luck there for him.
The Lions defense marching back onto the field now. They have a little something to build off of from last time with a three and out.
And what they have to build off of? Great confidence right now. Being able to stuff someone on a three and out, you feel like you're in control now. You're doing the dictating. They want to see if that can continue as this game progresses.
Will it continue? We'll see.
Encroachment defense.
And he got a little aggressive too early.
And he did, running that quick takeoff as the ball was snapped, but I think sometimes those big guys on offense, they're pretty cagey too, right? They make those little sudden moves or those little subtle moves that get you to jump.
Now a play fake here on first down. And nearly picked off there, and it would have been a great time for their first pick. Instead, it's second down.
Well, he did almost everything right. Excellent coverage, breaks on the football, just unable to haul it in and take it the other way. So he dropped an interception. The key for him now, don't dwell on it. Just move on to the next play.
Now Peterman on second down. And he's going to go down. Back near midfield at the 49. Ziggy Ansah in there to sack him for a loss of six. Well, they were coming out of the 4-3 defensively. Pressure coming off that right side from the DN.
And that's the blind side of most quarterbacks. If you're right-handed, that's the side you don't see quite as well. And that's why you rely on your left tackle, maybe your highest-paid offensive lineman, to take care of you. In this situation, that didn't happen.
The left side completion to Jones. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
And now a first chance for the backup here to throw. And this is incomplete. A huge gamble, and it does not pay off. They fake the punt. It doesn't work out.
Anytime a fake doesn't work, we usually focus our attention on the guys that were unsuccessful. But how about the defensive guys? They have to plan all week. They have to prepare all week. Special teams, it looked like they were educated for that one.
Educated on their toes and getting a big stop. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down.
Pretty nice covers there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
Here's Riddick, and nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on that one as it brings up a third and 10. And when you're running the football, one thing you don't want to see is a big boy coming up there and swallow you whole in those D tackles and nose tackles.
No, you're actually counting on your big boys to protect you from them. But on that play, the defensive tackle had the leverage, and he won the battle. No gain, correct?
No gain. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down.
As far as tight ends go, this guy's not a speed burner. He's much more of an inline blocking type of a tight end. But how about this last play? Made a nice catch and picked up a first down.
That's what impresses me about him. When he's called upon, he usually gets it done. Riddick with a carry. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
Back now in Buffalo. It's the Lions holding onto the football, and they also have the lead as we start quarter number four. They go back to Riddick. And this time the yards won't come so easy as they'll in fact tackle him behind the line. Now I think we're going to get a timeout here. Yes, a timeout here as it looks like we've got a Lion that's shaken up. Let's hope it's not anything that'll keep him out of the opener. We'll be right back. The Lions on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This will be third and 6. He'll look to throw. And they take him down. The Bills get to him.
Now that was just absolutely perfect man coverage. Nowhere for them to go with the football, led to a sack. And that's really difficult to do in today's NFL with all these gazelles running around that you're trying to cover in the secondary.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And that is incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Bills are going to get the football back. Boy, you talk about not playing it safe. Why were they going for it there, Charles?
It's got to be a full evaluation of their team. Do they trust their defense in this situation? Maybe they think they've given all they can in this game and they don't have anything left. Do they not trust that the other team's quarterback is just so hot that no matter where they get the ball, they go downfield? Remember when Bill Belichick went for it in that game, right, against Indianapolis on the road? And everybody said, why'd you go for it there? I think he just thought to himself, on the other side, if they get the ball, they're going downfield anyway. He was trying to end the game right there with his own offense.
Well, pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring,
This feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, but the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Jones spins away. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
That looked like a two-deep coverage, which we call cover two. And what that really means is you have corners, what we call rolled up in about a five-yard area on the outside receivers. Then your safeties are back closer to the hash marks near the middle of the field, somewhere around 10 to 12 yards back. So if you can break through the first level, you've got a chance to run before you encounter any type of resistance from the safeties.
We saw the example of it right there. In the red zone this time.
All right, here we go. Green, 39. Green, 39.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
Again, it's Jones, and he'll get about four there as he takes it from the 10 down to the 6.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
Here we go, third and one. Gut check time on both sides. From the gun, it's Peterman, and unable to connect. If he had caught it, it would have been a first down. Instead, it's fourth.
Just looking at it from a defensive perspective, when you break the huddle in the red zone, tight end is one of the guys you've got a key on, because quarterbacks want the ball in their hands fast in this position, and they want to get it to someone. And in this case, he has
it. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. A great play there. A 6-yard touchdown run. And the Bills have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter.
I wonder if he changed anything on his play sheet or they just executed better. Because they had two previous drives that ended in field goals before this one they finally were able to put into the end zone.
Well, whatever he did, speaking of the offensive coordinator, might be using that formula going forward. It worked there.
Yeah, it worked very well. He and his field general in pretty good sync right now. They're starting to move the ball well.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. So the Lions offense ready to go back out onto the field. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. He was looking for Theo Riddick there. That'll bring up second down. But not to get too overcritical there because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it. And he gets those shoulders right, that pass will go from incomplete to complete.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
It's a lot of contact going on there. And in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. He'll drop to throw. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. I don't know. He had to be pretty quick with his fingers to start and stop after the ball hit the ground. I'm giving him some credit.
Well, I'm thinking about the mental focus, you know.
Yeah.
The mental focus.
Yeah,
the whole
that's
thing.
True.
Got to stay with it.
That's true. And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. Jones on the return. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt. And the Bills will take over the football with a first and 10. They go play action here on first down. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
On second down, it's Jones. And 3 yards there takes him to the 45.
And this is an absolutely big third down that's been set up here, partner. And there's no other way to put it. The defense has to get a stop here if they have any hopes of winning this game.
Pastor, you said big third down. I'd put the word big in capital letters here. Peterman. And he's going to be out of bounds, but able to take it inside the 40-yard line. It's a pickup of 17 on that one, and a Bills first down.
Couldn't just sit on it here, could they? Had to throw the ball on third down, got the big completion in the pickup. Fresh set of downs now. They've got to feel great.
And defensively, a backbreaker. Throwing now, Peterman on first down. And no, it's he'll go down. They got him for a sack. At this stage of the game, time a factor, time on their side as they just try to eke out the final precious moments of this one.
Here we go now. 3-19.
On second down, here's Peterman. And he's going to go down again. Ezekiel Ansah in there to take him down and to take us to the 2-minute warning. So it's Bills football here as we get you reset. They're facing a critical third down now as they try to hold on to this lead. So the D-line's going to spread out. Tolbert, the fullback. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. And quickly we're going to get another stop here with 1:54 left as they call the timeout defensively. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. From the left hash, this from 53 yards out. And Hauschka's kick is good. And that extends their advantage to 6. It's 16-10. So they get the 3 here, but you wonder whether that's going to be enough.
Yeah, I mean, you've now made it so they need a touchdown rather than a field goal to catch them. But you're right. If they'd gotten 6 out of that drive, this would be a much different game.
And Detroit getting set to go now. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. So a loss of 5, and it'll be second down. To throw over the middle, it's Fells, and he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down. Back to throw, and nearly intercepted there. That would have been ball game if he had clinched it and caught it. Instead, it gives him one more chance here on fourth down. What a great sequence by this defense so far. They've given him nowhere to go with the football.
And they just have to make it stand up one more time because it appears that they've got their number. Can they not have a slip up here and allow the touchdown?
It's caught, Jones. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense, as he'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down.
Here we go. Green, 39.
He'll look to throw. And this is caught by Fowles, right side. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. The Lions need to move. They're hustling to the line now. They'll look to throw. He's got his tight end. It's Fells. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line.
Detroit!
2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs. He's back to throw. And he rifles one incomplete.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. Now he'll look to throw here on 2nd and 10. And some room to work. And nothing but daylight ahead. And he will score. Touchdown, Buffalo.
Partner, I do know this. If you're a defensive back, you have more chances to make a team now than ever because people are using 5 defensive backs, 6 defensive back packages. Not exclusively, but way more than before. That was a nickel package there, and what a pickoff.
Why is that? Why are they using that more?
Because more people are throwing the ball on earlier downs than ever before. This has become a passing league, and because of that, more defensive backs on the field on most plays. I know they didn't tack on the 2 points, but I liked their attempt. After the interception return for a touchdown, I was thinking to myself, forget kicking it, go for two, and they did.
Oh, yeah, and everybody's scrambling. Maybe you catch the defense on their heel. Now on the return. Oh, no, the ball is loose. And that might just cement it. A return for a late touchdown.
Well, I've got to laugh here, and I really don't want to because the old school in me is not happy about this score this late, not necessary. But this is Madden, isn't it?
Yeah.
This is how it works.
Rub it in. Have a day.
I mean, what does it matter? These guys who are playing in this game, there are no feelings
exactly.
There.
They don't have to face the guy. Well, they might if they're in the same room going head to head.
But that's
the
about
virtual
it.
Guys on the screen don't have to face each other after this one.
In that case, run it up.
And that one makes this a 19-point game. So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And Detroit getting set to go now. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in the game like this and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And the coach called a running play and pretty much said to
looking for Jones and it's intercepted. Good positioning and it's picked off. And he is going to score. It's a pick six and a Bills touchdown. Pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown. Door closed, locked, reinforced.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. After the pick six, they go right back to the air. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that will be incomplete as time has run out on this football game. And Charles, you know what coaches always tell us. We want to win our home games. That much we know. We want to protect our home turf. They got that done in this one.
Exactly.
Made it to see.
see a whole nother summer and it feel good. Stop now, top down, through the neighborhood. Let the wind blow, open up the window. That girl is poison like Belvia DeVoe. We have a barbecue to do at fall. Swimming pool party in the back on the low. And the plates of food will be laid out for free. Little kids, get down. I have a bus pull up with Tommy the Clown to do the jerk. Get go to work and do that dance that'll make your whole body hurt. Playing Bombardier, Common Clear. This that time of the year for everybody to be boisterous. Rock with Snoop Dogg and rejoice to this.
As we go on, like we do. When it's hot outside, just chill with you.
Ooh.